Namaste, I'm Bhavna and today I'm going to show you so far the most requested recipe, and it's a Kaju Katli. Yes, Kaju Katli, it's a very popular, attractive Indian sweet, and contrary to what people think, it is really easy to make, and today I'm going to show you the easiest way of making it. I've been working on this recipe for so long now. I mean, I almost tried 3 to 4 times. I wasn't quite satisfied. Every time it was something was missing, and the last time I made it was perfect. And so I'm ready to share today. Here is the handy list of ingredients for making Kaju Katli with you all. So let's start. The same way you can make the badam or pista katli, meaning the almond and the pistachio. You can individually make the almond katli or the pistachio katli. But today I'm going to show you how you can make out of cashews. I have the heavy bottom pan, the pot heating here, and I have 1 cup of cashews. And from 1 cup of cashews, make the powder, cashew powder. And you can use the coffee grinder or any dry, you know, grinding blender that works best to grind the cashew. And into the pot, I'm going to add ghee, a teaspoon of ghee, clarified butter. So into the pot, and make sure you take the heavy bottom pan or pot. So about 1 teaspoon of ghee. It's already hot. So it already melted. Now here what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the cashew powder, the kaju powder, and the sugar, mix very well. Mix completely. Okay, so it is mixed now. Now today I'm making actually the kaju katli, but if you want to make the kaju barfi, you can add to the same mixture, you can add 1/4 cup of milk powder, the dry instant non-fat milk powder. You can add 1/4 cup of milk powder for the 1 cup of cashew powder, and that way you will make your kaju barfi. So there is 2 different things here, the kaju katli and the kaju barfi. Today I'm going to show you kaju katli, not the barfi. Kaju katli has a long shelf life than kaju barfi, because kaju katli, there's no dairy product at all. So, and ghee helps us to even actually keep the any sweet longer. So we have this ready, and I'm going to put that back onto the stove, and I'm going to add this mixture into the melted ghee. So add into the ghee, and keep the temperature on a medium heat. Give it a stir. We're gonna cook till the sugar is melted, absorbed into the cashew, kaju. So you have to keep stirring, just to make sure that it doesn't stick to the bottom and it doesn't get brown. Now into the center, I made a kind of well, and into the well, I'm gonna add a little bit of water. So about 3 to 4 tablespoons of water. And into the water, I'm gonna add the saffron strands, few strands of saffron, kesar, and then mix the kesar very well. Now mix everything. And now you have to keep stirring continuously till all the water is evaporated. Keep the temperature on a low to medium heat. If it starts sticking to the bottom, then you can turn up the stove now. so this Kaju Katli mixture is ready. You can see that the water is evaporated and the ghee has separated out a little bit. So that's where you know that it's done and ready to spread out onto the ungreased plate. I have this flat tray and it... So take out onto the ungreased plate and spread out evenly. And then make it smooth onto the surface and spread 1/4 inch thick, and then when it gets cooled down you can make the pieces out of it. So that was pretty quick, huh? Just mix the sugar and cashews and then add the ghee into the pot and then just stir a little bit and then into the center, make kind of well, and then add water, and into the water add saffron, kaser, and let it get absorbed into the water, and then mix again everything and just cook a little bit afterwards that. And it takes almost only total time to cook this, only 6 to 8 minutes, not more than that, because we don't want to make it brown or overcooked. So it's pretty easy and pretty quick as well. So, and the most thing is inexpensive that you can make in your home kitchen. Now for the decoration, it's completely optional, but I have this chandi work. It's called silver foil or silver leaves, that's what it is called. And you can use that onto the, you can spread onto the Kaju Katli, and it brings out the real nice look. It's a silver, actually silver leaves, so it's gonna be silver color anyway, and that looks gorgeous. You can find these at any Indian grocers, and they do not keep on the shelf, but you have to ask for it at the cashier, because it's very delicate, they don't keep on the shelf. And these are really really delicate, so you have to be very careful. So I'm going to show you how you can do this. You cannot even put your finger on it. So I'm going to just take one at a time, and then what you're going to do is you're going to put directly that onto the Kaju Katli. Hopefully I can do this too. Oh boy, very very delicate. All right, okay, I managed to do it this time, and I'm going to do the rest of the foil. So I'm going to take one more here. Oops, that's what the problem is. Very very delicate. You place that directly onto the Kaju Katli, just like that. Don't worry if you cannot do at all the places. It's perfectly fine if you have here and there. So I'm gonna finish rest of the silver. I have done spreading the silver leaves onto the whole Kaju Katris, and now it's time to cut. Now you can cut into the diagonal shape or the square, but most of the time you will see that they are in a diamond shape, which is kind of diagonally. You can cut diagonally. I'm ready to cut, and I have this knife. So cut diagonally, so you will get the diamond shapes, nice diamond shapes with the silver look. This time it has come out perfectly. I earlier did video 2 times for this Kaju Katli, but then I did not publish it, just because I wasn't quite satisfied with the result. But this way, definitely. And as I said, pretty easy, simple. You can make the badam katli or the pistachio katli same way. And you can actually make the even kaju rolls, you know, like spread it, instead of spreading it on the ungreased plate, you can take the wax paper. Onto the wax paper, spread this mixture, and then onto the mixture, onto this Kaju Katli mixture, you can also pour little bit of pistachio mixture, and then make the roll, and in the middle you will have a kind of pistachio katli, like a green color, and you know, surrounded area with the Kaju Katli, which is going to be a white. Looks great, and nobody will be able to even know that this is the homemade Kaju roll or Kaju Katli or Kaju Barfi. I can't wait to taste it. Exactly same way I used to eat in India. Perfect. And today I'm satisfied and I made it today for this recipe. Now ready to take out the kaju katlis. It has settled down even perfectly and ready to eat now. And so I'm using this to just take them out so it don't break. Actually they are hard enough now to handle, but just to be careful that we don't break them, I'm just using this. Or you can just slide out a little bit, that way you don't have to even worry about it breaking. So I'm going to show you. So what you can do is you can just slide out. As I said, they're hard enough now, so you can easily handle them just like that. So I'm going to show you the one piece I have here ready. Look at this, the texture and everything perfect, just like the, you know, you can get it from the sweet shop. I'm going to take out rest of the kaju katlis. I'm going to place them onto the tray. So I have the whole plate ready here. Look at this, it looks gorgeous. To give it a more flavor, you can also add cardamom powder, which is one of my favorite, but today I forgot all about it. So you can also add cardamom powder, but if you're adding cardamom powder, do not add in the beginning, add at very last, so that it doesn't get the color kind of black. And that's why actually I avoided adding the cardamom powder today, because it kind of get like kind of black color if you do not add at the right time. So most probably once it is cooked completely and when you're mixing at that time, at last you can add the cardamom powder. And also you can use the rose extract, the rose essence, but essence I sometimes avoid adding because my kids also eat that. So but you can also add even the vanilla, which is a new approach. You can also add vanilla, so a few drops of vanilla essence. So whatever you want to add, you can bring out the any flavor that you like. And also you can add the yellow color, like especially if you're making the saffron kaju katli, the kesar kaju katli, then you can add the yellow color to this sweet dish. But it's completely optional as it is. Even look at it, it looks wonderful. So I just kept it simple, natural. So this was all about the kaju katli. Thank you for watching and see you real soon with another sweet dish.